Meet Lou Sattelmaier. He makes his living traveling at the speed of sound. Sattelmaier lives in Brunswick, Ohio, but spends most of his time touring the country racing his famous Sonic Thunder jet funny car. At 285 miles an hour, it's an awesome display of speed and power.
Well, the engine in this car is 13 feet long. It's 12,000 horsepower of engine at Mach 1. It has 6,000 pounds of thrust, and as you can see, you're sitting right next to the big engine. And it came out of an F-2 fighter plane, so it makes it real interesting. It also out-accelerates the space shuttle when it takes off down the track, and it's nine times louder than a 747.
In 1971, Sattelmaier became involved in another race, the race against drugs, when his own children brought him into school for show and tell. The car was an instant hit with the kids, and it was then that he decided to use the appeal to help children stay away from drugs.
Well, you know, you need to have a vision in your life, you need to trust in God, and you need to, of course, put your mind to it and don't give up, and stay away from the bad habits. You know, there's a lot out there that we get temptations all the time, even as race drivers, and I think it's important that they would stick to it and say no to drugs.
So just give me an idea how you got started in racing this car.
Well, I had a phone call back in March of 1984, and a fellow was selling a jet-powered race car, and I went over and took a look at it. Sat in the car, and I felt kind of strange because it had the engine right behind me. And I began to research it, and I found out the car was a lemon, so I didn't buy it, and I got a hold of another car, which was this one here in Kansas, also in March of 84, and we decided to buy it, and or try to buy it, basically, try to get some loans for the car and then make a living with it. And it all happened pretty quick. In about 2 weeks' time, we had gotten some loans from the bank, and we were out there racing. It took a while to get the amount of runs we needed for our test and all that, and the test is quite complex. It's FAA inspected and approved and all that, so it's quite involved, to say the least.
Had you done any racing prior to that, any other kind of cars?
Well, I've made a living with the 1932 Ford I've had for about 30 years, and I had started in 1971 full time with that. And I had been living with that car, basically going to various schools doing anti-drug programs and also working for various sponsors doing displays at shopping malls. Of course, we raced the car somewhat as well, so we kept pretty busy with that car.
What's in the future for Lou Sattelmaier?
Well, our family, we're the race team. We travel the country right now, and we just like to increase our drug program. We'd like to build a drug education trailer, and then it'll double for our race car trailer as well, and meet and greet kids at the tracks as well as schools and all that, and even work with some of the adults, and just kind of, hopefully the kids, my children will be with me all the time and do this thing full time as we're doing now, and maybe they'll have their own cars, and it's really hard to say. We're just aiming to increase.
Tomorrow, Sattelmaier may wake up in a different town, on a different racetrack, and although the faces may change, the message won't. Get high on racing, not drugs. For Southwest Weekly, I'm Todd Morgano.